Thank you for joining for today's Coffee Break webinar. Today's topic is Brain Tumors That Cause Epilepsy, Resolving the Biological Mechanism. A glioma is one of the most common types of brain tumor. Glioma form from glia cells. Their presence can cause a host of symptoms, including seizures. Seizures are a common occurrence in over 70% of patients with low-grade gliomas and may lead to a severe deterioration of cognitive function. Understanding how gliomas intrude into neural circuitry and alter function could shed light on this clinically complex issue and one day improve a patient's quality of life. In this webinar, Armin Mortazavi investigates the role of a mutation common among epileptogenic gliomas and its impact on neural function using multi-electrode array technology. Armin Mortazavi is currently a research fellow at the National Institute of Health within the National Institute of Neurological Disorders and Stroke. He is an MD candidate at Georgetown University School of Medicine and works with Dr. Karim Zaghloul of the Surgical Neurology Branch, studying metabolic causes and consequences underlying epileptogenesis through in vitro models and electroencephalographic sorted human brain tissue.
Thank you for joining me. My name is Armin Mortazavi. I will be discussing a mechanism by which isocitrate dehydrogenase mutated gliomas may promote epileptogenesis. Tumor-related epilepsy is a clinically complex phenomenon as it consists of a brain tumor causing epilepsy. Up to 70% of patients with gliomas, which is the most common primary brain tumor, experience seizures within the course of their disease. Unfortunately, 40% of these patients are refractory to common anti-epileptic drugs. It has been demonstrated that IDH mutations are independently associated with seizures. In fact, more than 70% of patients with IDH mutated gliomas experience seizures, compared up to 40% with IDH wild-type gliomas. Seizures are a major contributor to poor quality of life and decline in neurocognition in these patients. Tumor-related epilepsy needs to be better elucidated in order to develop targeted treatments. We therefore sought to explore this phenomena through human patients and in vitro models. The IDH mutation has been well studied, as it is a common mutated metabolic gene in cancer. IDH mutations are believed to contribute to tumorigenesis in low-grade gliomas, as well as many other neoplasms. The IDH mutation alters tumor biology significantly, resulting in distinct metabolic changes, as well as methylation and transcription patterns. Neomorphic enzymatic activity of IDH mutations convert alpha-ketoglutarate to D2-hydroxyglutarate, which is a key feature in its pathogenesis. Using the MEA system, we culture primary rad cortical neurons and study how neuronal activity is altered by disturbances that may be observed in peritumoral environments. Specifically, we explored why IDH mutations often result in higher rates of seizures. Not only are we able to study neuronal activity, but we can incorporate MEA studies with downstream assays, such as protein expression, imaging studies, or metabolic investigations. Additionally, with this model, we can introduce pharmacological modifications in order to better investigate potential mechanisms of action. To investigate the role IDH-mutated gliomas play in epileptogenesis, we created an in vitro model to recapitulate the peritumoral environment. We utilized Transwell inserts with either IDH-R132H or IDH wild-type murine glioma cells overlying primary rad cortical cultures on microlectrode arrays. In the presence of IDH-R132H glioma cells, neurons demonstrate increases in the number of bursts of neuronal spiking per second compared to activity in the presence of IDH wild-type cells. In order to better elucidate this mechanism, we sought to first inhibit the IDH mutation using AG120, a small molecule inhibitor of the mutated IDH enzyme. The increases in bursting activity we saw with IDH-R132H interactions were eliminated in the presence of AG120. We examined whether the increases in neuronal activity in the presence of IDH-mutated glioma cells are related to the product of IDH mutant metabolism, which is D2-hydroxyglutarate. IDH-R132H cells in the Transwell insert result in a significant increase in the levels of D2HG in the supernatant compared to levels observed in the presence of wild-type cells. This increase is reduced in the presence of AG120. We therefore hypothesize that D2HG may be the putative agent that is involved in increasing neuronal activity. To examine this, we directly treated the mixed neuronal culture with D2HG in the absence of IDH glioma cells. Direct treatment with D2HG causes similar increases in the rate of firing and spiking bursts compared to control cultures. We were interested in understanding the cellular mechanisms through which D2HG may lead to increased neuronal spiking activity. We observed that cortical rat neurons treated with D2HG demonstrate increases in LDHA expression, suggesting that D2HG may promote metabolic changes in the cortical culture. Additionally, following treatment with D2HG, maximal mitochondrial respiration increases as compared to control cultures. We examined these metabolic changes further using liquid chromatography, mass spectrometry, to compare metabolite enrichments between cortical cultures treated with and without D2HG. Treatment of the mixed cortical culture with D2HG caused distinct shifts in metabolites compared to control. In the presence of D2HG, cortical cultures exhibit significant enrichment of the end products of glycolysis and the TCA cycle, reflecting an overall increase in central carbon metabolism. In 5 participants with confirmed low-grade IDH mutated gliomas, we had the opportunity to examine resected human peritumoral cortical tissue that was identified as epileptic or non-epileptic through intracranial electrode monitoring. Similar to the cortical cultures, epileptic cortex also exhibits significantly elevated LDHA expression compared to non-epileptic cortex, as visualized using multiplex immunofluorescence. These data suggest that the changes in LDHA expression observed in our cortical cell culture with D2HG are recapitulated in the human brain tissue lying adjacent to IDH-mutated gliomas that exhibit seizures. Our data suggests a link between elevated neuronal activity and changes in metabolism in the context of IDH-mutated gliomas. One possibility is that these changes may involve mTOR signaling, which is both a major regulator of metabolism and which has also been implicated in epilepsy. To examine this possibility, we probed for the phosphorylation of ribosomal protein S6, a surrogate marker for mTOR activation. Cells treated with D2HG exhibited increased phosphorylated S6. These increases in phosphorylated S6 are eliminated when treating with the mTOR inhibitor, rapamycin. Rapamycin also eliminates the increases in LDH expression. Increases in maximal mitochondrial respiration observed with D2HG treatment are also corrected with rapamycin. These data therefore suggest that the changes in metabolism observed in the presence of D2HG may be related to mTOR activity. Complementing the changes in mTOR activity observed in the mixed neuronal culture, we also found that epileptic human cortex adjacent to IDH-mutated gliomas exhibit significantly higher levels of phosphorylated S6 expression compared to peritumoral non-epileptic cortex. These changes in phosphorylated S6 expression co-localize to cortical neurons and are consistent across all participants. The increases in mTOR signaling and the changes in metabolism observed in the setting of D2HG may simply be a result of increased neuronal activity. To exclude this possibility, we therefore investigated the effects of D2HG on metabolism and mTOR signaling when neuronal activity is silenced using the sodium channel inhibitor tetrodotoxin, or TTX. Application of TTX to our mixed neuronal culture significantly reduces neuronal bursting even in the presence of D2HG. Despite the significant reduction in neuronal activity, however, the presence of D2HG still increases maximal mitochondrial respiration compared to cells that were not exposed to D2HG. Even though TTX silences neuronal activity, neuronal cultures treated with D2HG in the presence of TTX still exhibit significant upregulation of phosphorylated S6 and LDHA, suggesting that mTOR activity and associated metabolic changes do not emerge in the presence of D2HG solely due to increased spiking activity. As the metabolic changes observed following exposure to D2HG appear to emerge independently of the increases in spiking activity, we hypothesize that mTOR activation and associated metabolic shift may in fact promote greater neuronal activity. In this scenario, IDH-mutated gliomas lead to elevated spiking activity, primarily through the effects of D2HG on the metabolic profile of the surrounding cells. To examine this, we treated cortical cultures with D2HG and rapamycin. The increases in bursting activity observed with D2HG compared to control cells are eliminated when the mTOR pathway is inactivated in the presence of rapamycin. In summary, IDH-mutated gliomas produce large amounts of D2HG. The D2HG in the peritumoral environment promotes major disruptions to the adjacent cortical tissue. Specifically, we hypothesize that D2HG upregulates mTOR signaling in neurons, which in turn causes metabolic reprogramming and epileptic more activity. I would like to acknowledge and thank those who contributed to this work. Thank you for your attention.
And that is the conclusion for today's Coffee Break webinar. If you have any questions you would like to ask regarding the research presented, or if you are interested in presenting your own research with microelectrode array technology or impedance-based assays, please forward them to coffeebreak@axionbio.com. For questions submitted for Armin Mortazavi, he will be in touch with you shortly. Thank you for joining in on today's Coffee Break webinar, and we look forward to seeing you again.